I have here a 3D printout of a patient who is a 12-year-old, and you can see all the bones are shattered, including the bottom jaw, the upper jaw, the eye sockets. Most critical, however, was that he could not see in both eyes. The eye doctors, the ophthalmologists, felt that the left eye was permanently blind. The chance of us being able to help this was extremely slim. And on the CAT scan, I couldn't see exactly what was going on, so we 3D printed the model, and it's exactly this model. You can see the broken jaw, you can see his eye sockets. And with this model, it's much more clear that this bone that we colored a little bit brown was tilting in and pushing on the optic nerve. We had a lot of discussion with the ophthalmologist, is it worth going after or not? And we decided maybe it's worth the chance. So I went to the operating room, and unfortunately, because this kid lost so much of his frontal bone as well, usually I'd have to go under the eyeball to get to this, but instead I went under the brain to get to this bone, and I pivoted it and tilted it and sewed it to the skull base here so that it was out of the way of the optic nerve, just hoping that this would help. I also fixed the bottom jaw and other things. And so actually we have a 3D print of the patient after the surgery. And after the surgery, you can see that the bottom jaw is completely lined up and normal now. And you can see that that bone is away. And amazingly, about 8 weeks later, the patient's vision completely came back in that eye. And that's incredibly rare and incredibly lucky, and we're incredibly grateful it happened. But I would say that without the 3D model, we would not have known exactly which bone to move. And this is a very crowded space. There's not a lot of room for error. And so I think that could not have been done had we not had the 3D printed model for that surgery.